Well, welcome students. In the last video lecture, we had done few of the smaller sums, calculating the new profit and loss sharing ratio and the gaming ratio. Now, today in this video lecture, I am going to explain you how to write the journal entries related to goodwill. These two points are basically, this type of sums are not asked in the examination, but are very important from the calculation point of view of the bigger sums, because these type of points or adjustments would be coming in the bigger sums. So they are very important from the point of view of bigger sums. So for that, the few sums are there in your textbook, that is question number 4. In that, I'll be doing 3rd, 4th and 5th sum of question number 4. So first of all, let us read question number 3 of your textbook, that is on page number 265. L, M and O are partners sharing profit and loss in the ratio of 5:4:3:3. You can see the old ratio I have written over here, that is 5:4:3:3. Now out of that partner, L is retiring. Total out of 4 partners, first partner, that is L partner, is retiring. At the time of retirement of L, goodwill appears at rupees 75,000 in the books of old firm. Old firm means before the retirement of the partner L, the goodwill that was existing in the old balance sheet, that is given to you rupees 75,000. Students, already we discussed that this goodwill is to be distributed amongst all the partners, including the retiring partner. So over here, all the partners will be getting the share of goodwill, because this goodwill was earned before the retirement of partner L. So partner L will also get the share of goodwill that was existing before his retirement. Okay, so 75,000, that is to be distributed in old ratio, that is 5:4:3:3. Always the old goodwill that is existing in the firm before the retirement of any of its partner is to be distributed amongst all the partners in their old profit and loss sharing ratio. Okay, so over here, L's capital, that is partner's capital. So the journal entry that would be partner's capital account debit to goodwill account credit. So partners, that are 4 partners, L's capital account debit 25,000, M's capital account debit, that is 20,000, N's capital account debit, that is 15,000, O's capital account debit, that is 15,000, to goodwill account credit, that is total 75,000. Now in which ratio? You will divide 75,000 in 5:4:3:3. So you will get this 4 value. Okay, now the next point comes, that is last line you can read in the question. On L's retirement, the goodwill of the firm is valued at rupees 90,000. Now this is the new goodwill after the retirement of partner L. So this goodwill is to be distributed amongst the continuing partners in their gaining ratio. In admission, what we are doing? This goodwill was distributed amongst the existing partners in their sacrificing ratio. Over here, this goodwill will be distributed amongst the continuing partners in their gaining ratio. Okay, so first of all, we have to find the gaining ratio in order to write the next journal entry to distribute the share of goodwill of the retiring partner. So gain formula, you are knowing, that is new share minus old share, that is totally the opposite formula of sacrifice. To find sacrifice, which formula we are utilizing, students? That is old share minus new share. Over here, new share minus old share. So gain that would be of only 3 partners, that is M, N and O. Okay, so M's gain, that would be new share that is given to you 3/5. Now that 3/5, it is already given in the question, 3:1:1. So 3/5 minus old share, that is 4/15 of M. So 4/15. So 3/5 minus 4/15. LCM, that would come to 15. So 5 3s are 15, 3 3s are 9. So 9 minus 4 upon 15. So it would come to 5/15. Same way for N. N new ratio, that is coming to 1/5. So 1/5 minus old share, that is given to you 3/15. So minus 3/15. They are subtracting it. They are taking the LCM, same LCM, that would come 15 over here. So 5 3s are 15. 3 minus 3, it would come to 0. So no sacrifice and no gain in case of N. Now in case of O, O also the same situation would be there, because the new and old ratio are same over there. So new ratio is 1/5. So same 1/5 minus old share, that is of O, is also same, that is 3/15. So minus 3/15, again it would come the same, that is 0/15. So it is 0. It means no gain, no sacrifice in case of 2 partners, that is N and O. It means the entire share of retiring partner's goodwill will be gained by only 1 partner, that is N. Students, for this goodwill, whatever the share of the retiring partner is to be distributed amongst the continuing partners in their gaining ratio. Over here, the continuing partner or the gaining partner is only one, that is partner M. So you can see the second journal entry that I have written, that is M's capital account debit, that is continuing partner. Over here, there is only one partner that is gaining. So M's capital account debit to L's capital, L is a retiring partner. So to L's capital account credit, that is rupees 30,000. How this 30,000 came? That is total goodwill is given to you 90,000. 90,000 multiplied by 3 by 15. If you do, you will get the value that is 30,000, that is retiring partners, 5 by 15. Because the share of the retiring partner, that is 5. Okay, that is 5 by 15. So 90,000 you will be doing multiply by 5 by 15. So 15 ones are 15 6 are. So 6,000 multiply by 5, that would come to 30,000. So the retiring partner's share of goodwill, that would come to 30,000, and that will be gained by only one partner, that is partner M. So our journal entry, again repeating, that is continuing partner's capital account debit to retiring partner's capital account credit. Over here, the continuing partner, gaining partner, that is only one M, and retiring partner, that is L, amount that would come to 30,000. So this was the first sum related to accounting entries of goodwill. Now moving on with the question number 4 of the same question. Question number 4. A, B and C are partners of a firm. B retires. There are 3 partners, A, B and C, and out of that partner B is retiring. At the time of B's retirement, the goodwill of the firm is valued at rupees 60,000. It means this is the new goodwill, that is not the old goodwill. Okay, the new profit and loss sharing ratio of A and C decided at 7:2. It means old ratio is also given to you, and the new ratio, you can see I've written on the board, that is old ratio of A, B and C, that is 1:1:1. It is not clarified that which ratio, the old ratio is not clarified. If it is not clarified, it is understood that the ratio would be in equal proportion. So A, B and C old ratio, that would be 1:1:1, and new ratio has been specified in the question, that is between A and C, because B is retiring. So then our new ratio would be between A and C, that is 7:2:2. Now first of all, we have to find the gaining ratio, because we are knowing the share of the retiring partner is to be distributed amongst the continuing partners in their gaining ratio. So first of all, because both the ratios are given, so we have to find the gaining ratio. Gain formula, you are knowing, that is new share minus old share. Now for A, the new ratio, that is 7:9 minus old share, that would be 1:3. Taking the LCM, that is 9, so 3:3, so over here 7 minus 3 upon 9, 7 minus 3 would come to 4, so 4:9, so gain, that would be 4:9. And the second partner C is equal to new ratio, that is given to you 2:9, 2:9 minus old share, again the same, that is 1:3, taking the same LCM, that is 9, so 3 threes are 9, 2 minus 3 upon 9, 2 minus 3 means -1:9. Now over here, whenever by the formula of gain, if the answer comes negative, then it is called the sacrifice. Already we discussed in chapter number 4, that is reconstruction of partnership, that by applying the formula of gaining ratio, if the answer comes negative, then it is called a sacrifice by that partner. In the same way, by applying the sacrifice ratio formula, if the answer comes negative, then it is gained by that partner. Over here we are applying gaining ratio. If by applying the gaining ratio the answer comes negative, then it is called sacrifice by that partner. So here the partner C is sacrificing and partner A is only gaining. So whatever the share of C that he is sacrificing, that share of sacrifice of C will also be given to A. So now A will be receiving 2 share, one share that is of C, and another share of B, that is the retiring partner. So both the share of B and C will be given to A. Okay, so over here, first of all, we are finding the share of B and C, that will be given to A. So share of B is equal to total goodwill that is given to you 60,000. Out of 60,000, share of retiring partner, because 1:1:1, so 1:3, so it would come to 20,000. Okay, now share of C, what is the share of C? That is total goodwill 60,000 multiplied by sacrificing. How much part is sacrificing? So 1:9. So here's the share of goodwill that would come to multiply by 1:9. So it would come in points. So round figure that I've taken, that is 2667, cancelling the decimals. So now 20,000 and 2,667. It means total 26,600. Sorry, mistake has been done over here. It would come 6,667. So total the amount of goodwill share that is received by A, that is 26,667. Both the share of B and C will be obtained by partner A, because here the partner C is sacrificing. So he has also to sacrifice the share of goodwill in favor of A. So the journal entry that would come only one, because old goodwill is not given in the question. Only the new goodwill is given to you after the retirement of the partner B. So again, revising the journal entry, that is continuing partner's capital account debit to retiring partner's capital account credit. Over here, the continuing partner, there are two, that is A and C, but C is sacrificing. So entire share, his share also will be given to A. So only the gaining partner, that is A. So A's capital account debit to B's capital account credit to C's capital account credit, because this two share is gained by partner A. So to B's capital account credit, that is 20,000, we have already found over here, and to C's capital account credit, that is 6,667. So total amount that is gained by partner A, that is 26,667. Okay, so there was only one journal entry, but to find the value, we have to show this working note. Okay. Now, moving on with the next and last sum for today, that is question number 5. Let us read that question. That is, B, R, T and S are partners sharing profit and loss in the ratio 4:3:1:2. There are 4 partners, that is B, R, T and S, and their old profit and loss sharing ratio that is given to you 4:3:1:2. Out of that, the first partner, that is B, is retiring. Goodwill is appearing in the books at the time at rupees 20,000, and at the time of B's retirement, goodwill is valued at rupees 60,000. Means both goodwill are given to you before the retirement and after the retirement. So before the retirement, whatever the goodwill is existing, it is to be distributed amongst all the partners, including the retiring partner, in their old profit and loss sharing ratio. So here you can see the first journal entry that I have written of the old goodwill. The old goodwill that is given to you in the question, that is rupees 20,000. So that 20,000 is to be distributed in the old ratio. What is the old ratio? That is 4:3:1:2. Okay. So B's capital account debit, R's capital account debit, T's capital account debit, S capital account debit to goodwill account credit, that is rupees 20,000. In which ratio? That is 4:3:1:2. So it would come to 8,000, 6,000, 2,000 and 4,000. Okay. So first journal entry, always the old goodwill will be distributed amongst the all the partners, including the retiring partner, in their old profit and loss sharing ratio. Now, in case of the new goodwill, to find the new goodwill, we have to find the gaining ratio. Over here, both the ratios are given to you in the question. That is old ratio 4:3:1:2, and the new ratio that is given to you, that is 1:2:2. So first of all, we have to find the gain. As usual, gain formula you are knowing, that is new share minus old share. Gain that would be of only the 3 remaining partners, because B partner is retiring. So now the gain we have to find out of only 3 partners, that is R, T and S. Okay, so new share, that is 1/5 for R, minus old share that would come to 3/10. Taking the LCM, that would come to 10. So 5, 2s are 10. So 2 minus 3, it would come to minus 1. Minus 1. Already we discussed in the last one that if by applying the formula of gain, if the answer comes negative, then it is sacrifice. Okay. So partner R is sacrificing his share of goodwill. Now in case of T, again the same LCM, that would come to 10. What is the new share? That is new share of partner T, that would come to 2. So 2/5 minus the old share, that would come to 1/10. So again, same LCM, that would come to 10. So 5 2s are 10, 2 2s are 4. 4 minus 1, that would come to 3/10. So positive answer is coming, so he is gained. Now in case of S partner, the new ratio, that is 2/5 minus the old share, that is 2/10. So 2/5 minus 2/10, taking the LCM 10. So 5 2s are 10, 2 2s are 4. 4 minus 2, it would come to 2/10. Okay, so these two partners are gaining and this partner is sacrificing. So first of all, we have to find the sacrificing share of partner R. How much share of goodwill that he is sacrificing in favor of these two partners, that is T and S. So students, those partners who are gaining, that will be debited, and those partners who are sacrificing, they will be credited. Over here you can see the journal entry. T's capital account debit that is given to you, amount that will decide later on. T's capital account debit, S capital account debit. These are the two partners that are gaining. So continuing partners, capital account debit. Over here, the gaining partners are T and S. Okay. So T's capital account debit, S capital account debit to B's capital account credit. Now B is the retiring partner. So B's capital account credit to R's capital. Why this R came over here? Because R is getting the sacrifice. So he has also to sacrifice his share of goodwill in favor of these two partners, that is T and S. In which ratio? That is 3:2. You can see 3:10 and 2:10. So which ratio they will be distributing? That is 3:2. Okay. Now first of all, we have to find the share of B and R. Okay. So first of all, B's share, total goodwill that is given to you 60,000. Out of 60,000, the share of retiring partner, the retiring partner is B, so his share is 4 by 10, so 60,000 into 4 by 10, it would come to 24,000. And R, that is the partner that is also sacrificing in favor of the two other continuing partners, so R share is equal to 60,000 multiply by, answer came negative 1 by 10, so multiply by 1 by 10, that would come to 6,000. So total 30,000 is to be distributed in the remaining two partners, that is partner T and S, in which ratio? That is in 3:2 ratio. Okay, so the journal entry, that is the second journal entry, you can see on the board. T's capital account debit, S capital account debit, total 30,000, that is distributed in 3:2 ratio, it would come to 18,000 and 12,000. To B's capital account credit, what is the share of goodwill of the retiring partner? That is 24,000. And to R's capital account credit, that is the sacrifice of his share of goodwill, that is rupees 6,000. That came by showing this calculation, that you can see 60,000 multiplied by 1 by 10. So his share of sacrifice of goodwill, that would come to 6,000. So to B's capital account credit, that is 24,000. And to R's capital account credit, that is rupees 6,000. Okay, students. So this was the few of the sums that I have selected, especially for finding the value of goodwill and how to write the journal entries. In the bigger sums, you have to do the posting of this journal entries in the concerned accounts. So that's all for today, students. Do revise again from the video lecture, because this point of goodwill is very important. Till then, goodbye. Stay blessed.